Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. I thought I might be the only one walking up St. Martha's this morning, but there seem to be other people here as well. What are we all looking for? What was Mary looking for that first morning? Certainty. As in, she knew she had to go and anoint the body properly. That's what you had to do. A man-made ritual. How was she going to get into the tomb? Get past the soldiers, roll the stone away. But she knew what she had to do. Certainly the strangest Easter of my lifetime, and one of the strangest Easters ever this year. We can't meet in church. Church is shut. We can't meet our friends and our families, except on means like this. But do we cling to the buildings and the rituals, the certainty of man-made things? Why am I walking up this hill this morning? Because it's what we used to do. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They've taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they've put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realise it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you're looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I'll get him." First encounter someone has with the risen Jesus is Mary, again. And she doesn't recognise him. Eyes blinded by tears. Or this just was the unexpected. Jesus is always doing the unexpected. You know it's Jesus because he replies a question with a question. A I suppose, where are we looking for Jesus? Expected places? Unexpected people? Jesus, are you looking in the right places? Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. Jesus said to her, "Mary." It's only when her name is called that she recognizes him. Is that awesome? Jesus knows her by name. Of course she does. Of course your dad did. He also knows you by name. He knows me by name. And he's calling each and every one of us. The first thing he tells Jesus tells Mary is, "Do not hold on to me." In which case, what's Mary left to do? Go and tell other people. Mary's name has been called. Has your name been called out? If you're looking for Jesus in the wrong places, perhaps listen to him where he's calling you. Calling you to him, to know him, to have a relationship with him, but then to tell other people about him. crowd up here this morning, all keeping our social distancing. Heavenly Father, thank you that you have risen. Thank you that you call each and every one of us by name. Thank you that you draw people towards you. And I'd ask that you would meet each and every one of these people here this morning. You'd meet each and every one of us at Christ Church and our families this morning. May you send us out to tell the good news of Jesus. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. See what a morning glorious bright, with the dawning of hope in Jerusalem. Folded the grave clothes, tomb filled with light, as the angels announce Christ is risen. See God's salvation plan, brought in love, born in pain, paid in sacrifice. Fulfilled in Christ the man, for he lives, Christ is risen from the dead. See Mary weeping, where is he laid as in sorrow? She turns from the empty tomb. Hears a voice speaking, calling her name. It's the Master, the Lord, raised to life again. The voice that spans the years, speaking life, stirring hope, bringing peace to us, will sound till he appears, for he lives, Christ is risen from the dead. One with the Father, Ancient of Days, through the Spirit, who clothes faith with certainty. Honor and blessing, glory and praise to the King, with power and authority. We are raised with him, death is dead, love has won, Christ has conquered. And we shall reign with him, for he lives, Christ is risen from the dead. Amen. until the sun rises on a new day. Just like any other day. Or is it the greatest day in history, as the song goes? Thine be the glory, risen conquering sun. Endless is the victory the death hath won. Angels in bright raiment rolled the stone away, kept the folded grave clothes where thy body lay. Thine be the glory, risen conquering sun. Endless is the victory thou, O death, hast won. Lord Jesus meets us, risen from the tomb. Lovingly he greets us, scatters fear and gloom. Let the church with gladness hymns of triumph sing. For her Lord now liveth, death has lost her sting. Thine be the glory, risen conquering sun. Endless is the victory thou, O death, hast won. No more we doubt thee, glorious Prince of Life. Life is naught without thee, aid us in our strife. Make us more than conquerors through thy deathless love. Bring us safe through Jordan to thy home above. Thine be the glory, risen conquering sun. Endless is the victory thou, O death, has won. As you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans but chosen by God and precious to him, you also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed.